Hi, my name is Erinc from the band Mantar. I'm the drummer of Mantar, and yeah. All right. Death by Burning sounds really DIY and really raw, but in the first case it was not planned to do it as a two-piece, but we rehearsed as a two-piece and it went out perfectly and it worked out pretty fine, so we kept it like that. And yeah, that's about it. So the main thing about us is that we don't belong to a certain scene. We say that very often, but it's the truth. So I'm not into metal music that much. I never listened to metal music. I was hardcore punk rock, grunge, hard rock, and Hanno is also into heavy music. But the heaviness is the one thing that keeps us together. So I'm not a metal drummer, and Hanno is kind of a rock punk guitar player with a little bit of metal in it, and we don't try to change each other. We just do what we can do, and it's all about the heaviness of the music and not to sound like death metal, black metal, or doom metal or something. So we are doing music for quite a long time, and we achieved it in the age that we know what we want, so we don't think about doing music that fits in a lot of genres. The thing is, this is all what we can do, and if it fits in more genres than one, then it's all fine. So no, I wouldn't say that. Metal is more it's like more technical in doing, so it's all, I think it's all the, both styles are about the freedom of doing what you want, but metal is more better musicians than punk, so I think. But it's all about, I think, mainly the same energy levels that they are using. Well, how we write our songs is it's quite different. We are jamming not too much. We came up with ideas, and the thing is, while we're rehearsing, we are filming good ideas and stuff like, oh yeah, that sounds good, and this drum beat to that, okay, let's film it. We're collecting these little short films, and afterwards we are like looking at them and putting them together until we get a song out of it. So this is how we work, and it works good. Yeah. Well, the main thing is I want them to see that we are like honest musicians that are like sweating, I don't know, 5 gallons every night we are on stage, and we don't take it easy, and we are really, really hard working, and we're giving our best, and most people appreciate it and they see it, and that's all about. We want people to have a good time watching Mantar and not getting bored or something. We are putting a lot of energy in that and our stage time, so I hope the people enjoy it. Yeah. Well, everything is bigger here, so that's the main difference. When I was younger, I was always thinking about America and going there and touring there and playing shows, and people will like it or not, I don't know, and being big in America and stuff like that. Now that I'm older, it's like, okay, it's, if you're on stage, it doesn't matter if I'm playing in front of 5 people and I don't know, in a little place in Germany or like here, it's on stage. We are face to face on stage. I'm not looking at the audience, I'm looking at Hanno, and we are like playing for us, and the audience can be a part of it. So it doesn't make a difference, but it's cool to be here, and it's like all the movies I've seen when I was a child. It looks exactly the same, and sometimes it's hard to realize that you're really here, but maybe it will take 3 or 4 more tours, then we are aware of this is the USA. So. Oh, yeah, we are even riding on tour, so when we are in our tour van, we have like a little laptop and looking at videos and trying out and writing some stuff down, yeah. We don't have that much time because we are touring so much this year. We have like a big bunch of festivals we will play starting in June. And so we have to do the album kind of in between, at least write the songs, so we can maybe record it in the fall or something. That's the plan. You mean if it's exciting to play in front of a bigger audience than a smaller one? No, not really. It's fun to play in a packed room. So when the people like your music and they are standing in front of the stage and like dancing around or jumping and stuff. But I really appreciate it when we're playing in front of like 12 people and there's one guy who comes to us and says, "Well, I'm so glad you're here, and you know, I drove like 600 miles just to see you guys." And so it doesn't matter. So I liked it as much as a crowded house. So. Well, it's like a relationship between a couple. So sometimes we'll really argue a lot, and sometimes it's like we are the best friends. Yeah, it helps a lot. We know each other for, I guess, like 18 years or something. Yeah, it's a long time. We both were in different bands, so, and we started this band like about 15 years after we met each other. We started doing music together. So it's kind of weird. I don't know, but yeah, maybe this was what it was supposed to be. So. Well, there will be, like I said, a big festival season. I am starting late of May. We are playing Temples Festivals when we go fly over to Europe again in England. And then starting in June, we are going to be on festivals like every week. And in September, I think we are planning to go to Turkey to play there some shows. Maybe to Russia, it's something like that, and maybe another tour by the end of the year. So that's the plan. So we got like 1 month free this year, and maybe we can record some stuff at that time.